top headlines for the day.
Kapil Sharma is sorely missed on the weekend. And Colors Channel will not accept this, but Comedy Night's live first episode didn't catch the attention of the audience well. It received a lot of flack and criticism, and most important, Krishna Abhishek shouldn't have taken a dig at Kapil, as his loyal fan following blasted Krishna for that on social media sites. Now the inside cover is Kapil Sharma soon will be back on television where he's the king of comedy. Yes, he will be doing a show with Sony, though it was speculated with Star TV, but it seems Sony has got him for sure. And the news is that the show will be called Comedy Style. We say that it is superb style of Kapil to get back on colors. After all, the war is on. Kapil is back with Dadi, Guthi and Palak. Saina Nehwal is the first Indian badminton player to win the medal in Olympics. Amol Gupte, the filmmaker, is planning to make a biopic on Saina, and he intends to make a movie about Saina's journey to become the first Indian to win the medal in the badminton at Olympics. And who would be the choice to play the role other than very talented actress Deepika Padukone, daughter of an ace badminton player of India. And even Saina Nehwal wants the same. During the NDTV Indian of the Year Awards, Saina said that Deepika's father has been one of the best Indian badminton player and Deepika plays really well. So she can do justice to the role and she desires that Deepika plays the role. Deepika, also present at the awards, said she has played with Saina and she's always better than her and it is fun playing with her. Yeah, when it comes to teleserials, they're indeed worth a watch at times. Take the case of Nagin, for example. It is surprising how easily the stars of the serial have woven their way through their fans' hearts. As for the serial, well, Nagin is very popular due to its ancient theme and the concept is keeping the viewers engrossed. Obviously, with a handsome hunk like Arjun Bijlani playing the role of Hrithik in tow, things are heating up in the show. Add to this Moni Roy's amazing performance and things have become easy and convenient to make it a watchable serial. Apparently, Arjun is going to spring a surprise on the viewers with a Valentine's Day's performance with Tukur Tukur the Dilwale song, which is really popular among the masses. Well, the serial is surely attracting the attention of the Janta and people really have all the praises for this ACOT who's out to win hearts. Salman Khan is in the news for weird reason. This time it actually took the reward of being the most weird reason. Yes, the Khan was in a voter's ID office where a person had come to vote. The person, obviously a faker, had Salman Khan's photo and the name of his father is Salim Khan. However, this imposter was actually 64 years old as per the voter's ID. Our bhai is rocking at 50, so there is no remote possibility it could be the Dabang Bhaijaan's ID card. Things became dirty after the card came to the notice and he was disqualified in Charminar area of Hyderabad in a voting centre. Isn't it a bit strange the way the fans endorse their liking for their star? And as for the others, it is a case of amusement and shock, obviously, with Bhai always entangled in some mess or the other. Well, Bollywood meets Hollywood seems to be the name of the game right now. Yes, for those who are in touch with the latest news, they would surely know that Deepika is the next in the Hollywood bandwagon. After Priyanka's amazing take on Contigo, it was but obvious that another diva would hit it big too. But we did not expect it to happen so soon. So the best is waiting to happen with the Pico of Bollywood, but as our Mastani weaves her way through to Canada, we did see so many of her workout videos, all a great way of enhancing her already swelled body. Vin Diesel, who has already met Priyanka, would now get a taste of our filmistan's talents and would know why Bollywood is so creative and happening, would say. Deepika, meanwhile, has been really busy with her other movies, her award shows and her activities, but has now finally left for Canada where she would show her other talents, would say. Urvashi Rautela is talk of town with her bikini appearance in the film Sanam Re Song, but what we hear is quite shocking. Well, the lady was trying hard to get the attention of Sultan Films director Ali Abbas Zafar to be the leading lady. Ali Abbas was perplexed with not getting the heroine for his film, and so many speculations were rife, and in that, Urvashi was trying to be a bit too friendly. He told her to send her photos and his team will get in touch. Well, surely nobody got in touch with her, and soon the announcement on Twitter was made that Anushka Sharma has been selected to play the lead role in the film Sultan, starring Salman Khan. The onlookers said that Urvashi wasn't quite aware about the surroundings, and the director went red in face before telling her to send photos, and eventually he saved the day. Whoa, things are happening fast on the comedy front. Yes, didn't we all feel a tad disappointed that no longer would 10 at night mean comedy nights? Yes, we also did shed a tear on the last show of Couples Antics. Then entered Krishna on Colors, and viewers are yet to get used to him. Meanwhile, this news petered in that Comedy Nights would now be telecasted on Sony Channel. Isn't that really fun? Yes, so now you can sit back, relax and have fun at Couples' expense. Yes, all those out there who are used to Kapil Sharma, you just have to switch channels and then see his escapades with Guthi and company. Kapil Sharma has always had the talent to make people laugh. However, he made people cry on Colors channel. Now it is Sony TV ki bari, and everyone would love to have him back again, hai na? Whoops, at times stars too cannot afford stuff. Can you believe that? Yes, here is our own King Khan of Bollywood saying how difficult it is for him to get a private plane. Yes, the workaholic Khan is famous for his work routine, and everyone knows how he loves to be disciplined about his acting profession. However, he says he's unable to do a lot more as he does not have a private plane which would let him reach faster. So where does SRK spend his money that he mints? Well, apparently it is all in his movies that he produces. The Rais star is gearing up for another double release this year with Rais and Fan. The last time this happened was when the Chinna Express actor had his two flicks Dawn and Raw 1 release in the same year. Well, Deepika seems to have replaced the name of the Queen of Bollywood by etching her name on it. And who wouldn't agree that she's the Bollywood queen after her stellar performances in Piku, Bajirao Mastani and Tamasha? Yes, the undisputed Rani of Tinseltown also won the Indian of the Year award in the NDTV Awards functions. Obviously, her expressive boyfriend Ranveer was out with all the praises and tarif that she's worthy of, and explained how easy it is to act with her. When Deepika felt Ranveer is talking too much, she just chirped in between to dilute Ranveer's spontaneous energy. Deepika deserves to win all the awards this year after her hard work and dedication has entered the hearts of the janta, hai na? Meanwhile, Deepika is busy with her upcoming Hollywood stint, and isn't it a fitting farewell to her that she takes so many awards and then goes abroad to get more? Well, this is getting so cute by the day. Ain't it so cool that SRK and the King of Bollywood has such a cute little son who's grabbing more attention than his famous dad? Obviously so, cause the kid is cute, charming and smart like his dad. In fact, when SRK's pic with Abraham was put when he landed in Gujarat for the Rais shoot, a fan had tweeted back, "So cute." Yes, the true relationship between father and son SRK and Abraham is just that, cute and so warm. Shah Rukh is busy with two releases this year, Rais and Fan, yet he has the time to carry his child around while he's moving out for shoots. Very soon, a director would spot the charming Abraham and catapult him to the top like his dad would say. Won't we love to have another SRK performing the way he does? Well, when it comes to movies and parties, Bollywood certainly tops the list. Look at this promo of Kapoor & Sons, the upcoming Siddharth Alia movie, which also has the Pakistani talent Fawad Khan in tow. With everyone in the pic seems to have fun, we feel we can also be a part of their celebration eventually when it is released in the theatres. So this is the party we are talking about, and we still don't know who's going to host it. We just assume that the happening couple Siddharth and Alia are throwing it in the flick. Anyway, even Fawad Khan is seen having fun, and we look forward to seeing this Pakistani dude belt it out, I'd say. So we are in again for another Student of the Year kind of experience maybe. Till then, enjoy this poster. Poor TRPs have resulted in many excellent shows going off air. The channels and the producers take the decision, and well, it could mean that Ek Tha Raja and Ek Thi Rani might go off air. The show has not been able to garner that good of a response from viewers, and the TRPs being low, there are talks about pulling the show off air. It is said that the show will go off air by March. It is kind of a sorry state for such a good show which has such good actors. The makers say that they have tried everything to make the show a success, but nothing is working so far. All tricks have been used and actors are doing their best, but if things don't improve, it might go off air in March. Siddharth Karnik, the lead actor, however, says all these are rumors, and he said that if these developments do happen, the actors are last to know.